Welcome to another geography class. Welcome to today's class we're looking at porosity of rocks. Now we have different types of rocks, right? We have igneous rock, we have metamorphic rock, we have rocks that you call sedimentary rocks, but we're not looking at that specifically naming. What we're looking at is porosity and non-porous rock. Okay, so let's first look at porous rocks. Have you ever seen a rock looking like this before? Seems as if somebody have actually taken a chisel and chiseled out sections in the rock. Well, this is a limestone rock. This is what you call a sedimentary rock, right? Now, this rock is shaped and curved with all these creases and joints, not because of human work or because of some accident. This rock is like this because of water. Now, rocks allow water through it is referred to as porous rocks. Some persons, well, some texts also refer to them as permeable rock. Right? Permeable rock allows water to go through it, while impermeable rock, in which I'll show you an example, does not allow water through it. Now, the limestone will allow water through it, and as the water goes through it, it actually washes out what you call calcite. For example, when you go to a cave and you see stalagmite and stalactite, all of that are byproducts of limestone, right? Wherein it's the water that is moving through the limestone would have actually been carrying it bits of calcite, and over time the building up of the drip from in the top of the cave will result in the formation of pillars, stalactites, and stalagmites. Okay, so you should understand what is meant by permeable and porous rocks. Now let us look at impermeable rock. This is a little tricky situation. You might say that this rock and this rock looks the same. However, this rock is a limestone rock anyway, right? While this rock is a river rock, and this is not permeable. This is what you call impermeable rock or non-porous rock. This rock does not allow water to go through it, right? This rock, evidence exists that this rock is a limestone rock with the holes that have been gorged in it. This suggests that the continuous beating of water on a section of the rock will lead to it actually falling apart. However, this rock will not allow that. What will happen with this rock in the river, and you mostly find these rocks in the river, right? What will happen with these rocks in the river is that these rocks will actually hit against each other, causing them to actually have a line of weakness, and it will fall apart. But as far as this rock is concerned, over time this rock will fall apart because it is a sedimentary rock. So impermeable rock does not allow water to go through it, while permeable rock allows water to go through it. It is hoped that today's lesson was of interest to you, and that you can now identify permeable rock from impermeable rock. Note that permeable rock allows water to go through it. That doesn't mean that you can hold your oars over the rock and watch to see the water actually comes through the rock. No, it is over time that the rock will allow the water through it, and in terms, the water eventually will break the rock apart. While impermeable rock, it will never be affected by the flow of water going through it. However, another piece of rock just like it might just hit on it, and it might end up falling apart. That's it for now. Have an awesome day. Bye bye for now. Cool.